In the previous video, we looked at the basic structure of missiles. In this video, we'll examine in more detail how missiles actually work. First, let's look at air-to-air missiles. Fighter jets cannot be heavily armored because they need to fly at high speeds. Therefore, anti-air missiles do not need to have very large warheads. Since fighter jets fly at high speeds, they are difficult to hit directly. But even exploding nearby can cause serious damage to the aircraft. If the maximum range exceeds 150 km, it is considered a long-range air-to-air missile. Around 50 km is medium range, and around 10 km is short range. Air-to-air missiles generally travel at speeds of Mach 4 to 5. This is a medium-range air-to-air missile. It has a radar seeker in the front, along with a guidance system, warhead, and rocket engine. After launch, it flies using inertial guidance and command guidance. When it gets close to the target, it automatically switches to active homing guidance using radar. Short-range air-to-air missiles mainly use infrared guidance that tracks the heat from a jet engine. Long-range air-to-air missiles are mainly used to destroy large enemy aircraft. Because they carry large warheads and include large radars, the missile itself is also large. The warhead is triggered by either an impact fuse or a proximity fuse. Next are air-to-ground missiles, which are launched from the air toward ground targets. Depending on the target, they are classified as anti-tank, anti-radar, etc. Hellfire is an anti-tank missile. It is launched from attack helicopters or unmanned combat drones. It has a laser seeker in the front. It uses a tandem warhead containing two shaped charges. Electronic systems control the flight, and a rocket engine is mounted at the rear. When the attack helicopter shines a laser on the target, the missile follows that laser to hit the target. A representative air-to-ground missile is the Maverick. A TV camera is mounted at the front of the missile. The pilot can view the camera footage on a monitor. When the pilot designates the target, the guidance system memorizes the image and flies toward the target. It boasts an accuracy rate of over 80%. It can be used for various purposes, including anti-tank and anti-ship operations. Missiles launched from ground to ground are called surface-to-surface missiles. The RPG-7 is an anti-tank missile. It can be carried by a single person and is simple to operate. It flies using a solid rocket and uses a shaped charge warhead. It is launched by a booster, and the engine activates after flying about 10 meters. This is the second generation anti-tank missile, TOW. It is equipped with a tandem warhead to defeat reactive armor. The small warhead at the front destroys the reactive armor, and the larger warhead at the back penetrates the main armor. This is the third generation anti-tank missile, Javelin. It is equipped with an infrared imaging seeker to track the target. It can distinguish the infrared emitted by the target from the surrounding infrared images. Even if the target moves, it can track it using the memorized image. It can attack armored vehicles, buildings, and even low-flying helicopters. This is the Scud missile. It is a ballistic missile developed by the Soviet Union using Germany's V-2 technology. It uses a liquid rocket system with liquid fuel that can be stored at room temperature. It uses large vehicles as launch platforms, providing high mobility and making it difficult to detect. Ballistic missiles are classified by range. Short-range ballistic missiles have a range of up to 800 km. Intermediate range, ballistic missiles up to 2,500 km. And intercontinental ballistic missiles over 500 km. ICBM are literally missiles that fly across continents. They carry multiple nuclear warheads. With nuclear warheads, they can fly to targets 10,000 km away. A three-stage solid rocket carries the warhead into space, and a fourth-stage rocket separates the nuclear warhead toward the target. Thermonuclear warheads, which combine atomic and hydrogen bombs, are mainly used. The fourth-stage rocket uses a liquid fuel engine with controllable thrust to precisely control its attitude. It flies using an inertial navigation system and corrects errors using a satellite navigation system. ICBMs can be launched using vehicles or from underground silos. A three-stage solid fuel rocket engine is used to gain altitude. The engine burns for about 5 minutes. Once all rocket engines have burned out, it reaches outer space, where there is almost no air resistance. Because ballistic missiles travel in a parabolic trajectory, they must reach a high altitude to fly long distances. ICBMs ascend to altitudes of 1,000 to 1,500 kilometers and then fall back down due to gravity. Several nuclear warheads can independently separate and engage multiple targets. Upon re-entering the atmosphere, air resistance slows it down, but it still falls at high speeds, over Mach 4. Ballistic missiles can also be launched from submarines. These are called submarine-launched ballistic missiles. The missile is housed inside a launch tube, which is sealed by a hatch. Even if the hatch opens, a cover prevents water from entering. When the hatch opens, water flows into a passage next to the launch tube. When a small rocket ignites, it heats the seawater and turns it into steam. The high temperature, high pressure steam is directed into the launch tube. When high pressure air is also sent into the launch tube, the steam rapidly expands as it cools. When the internal pressure of the launch tube rises, the cover is destroyed and the expanding air is rapidly expelled, pushing the missile out. This high-pressure air also protects the missile underwater. After reaching the water surface, the missile ignites its first stage rocket and begins flight. Next is the surface-to-air missile, which is launched from the ground toward the air. There are many types, ranging from large-scale air defense systems to portable missiles that infantry can carry. Short-range surface-to-air missiles can attack fighter jets or helicopters and have a range of about 5 kilometers. Short-range surface-to-air missiles with a range of about 10 kilometers are used to defend key ground facilities. Long-range surface-to-air missiles are weapons for defending larger areas with a maximum range of about 50 kilometers. They are mainly used to intercept ballistic missiles. This is a MAN portable surface-to-air missile. It attacks enemy aircraft that infiltrate at low altitudes to avoid friendly radar. It can reach speeds over Mach 2. It tracks enemy aircraft using an infrared seeker. It can detect infrared wavelengths, allowing it to distinguish targets even when enemy aircraft deploy flares. It contains a blast fragmentation warhead weighing about 2.5 kilodalton and explodes using a proximity fuse. This is another type of low-altitude air defense weapon. First, radar is used to detect the target. Once the missile is launched, it flies guided by a laser beam. When the laser is aimed at the target, the missile is guided so that the laser enters the center of the aiming sensor at its rear. The missile flies toward the target at Mach 3. This is the Patriot missile. It was developed to intercept enemy aircraft and ballistic missiles. At the front of the missile is a radar seeker and small rockets for attitude control. There is a guidance system and a warhead containing small metal balls. A rocket engine is located at the rear. The Patriot missile flies using an inertial navigation system and information sent from the command and control center until the mid-course phase. As it approaches the target, it uses an active radar to home in on it. The Patriot missile contains micro-rockets that control its attitude. At high altitudes, the air is thin, making it difficult to maneuver using fins. Therefore, these small rockets fire sideways to control the missile's attitude. The Patriot missile directly collides with the ballistic missile to intercept it. Ballistic missiles are extremely fast. Since the interceptor missile also travels at high speed, the combined velocity of the two creates significant kinetic energy. As a result, interceptor missiles typically do not carry warheads. In addition to ballistic missiles, the Patriot can also engage aircraft, cruise missiles, and air-to-ground missiles. If a direct hit is deemed difficult, the warhead is detonated to release small metal fragments. This increases the effective interception radius. Ballistic missiles are divided into the following phases based on position. The period from launch until the rocket engine stops burning is called the boost phase. From the end of the rocket burn to the separation of the warhead is the post-boost phase. The phase during which the separated warhead travels through space before re-entering the atmosphere is called the mid-course phase. The phase from atmospheric re-entry to impact on the target is called the terminal phase. The terminal phase is the shortest and most difficult phase for missile interception. Modern Patriots have a range of about 30 km, but given the speed of ballistic missiles, interception occurs only about 10 seconds before impact. Therefore, a missile capable of intercepting at higher altitudes is necessary. SAD is a missile system that intercepts threats at high altitudes. It can intercept warheads in the upper layers of the atmosphere after they re-enter. The SAD system uses a special radar, which has a relatively short detection range but provides precise tracking. The detection range exceeds 500 kilometers. SSAD missiles fly using inertial and satellite navigation. As they approach the target, they use an infrared seeker for homing guidance. Small rockets are fired to control the missile's attitude. The missile directly hits the target, destroying it through kinetic energy. Next, let's take a look at missiles used on naval vessels. Warships are equipped with high-performance radar and anti-air missiles, making them difficult to attack. To protect friendly fleets from enemy missile attacks, the Aegis destroyer was developed. Aegis ships are equipped with high-performance radar panels on four sides, enabling 360-degree target detection. With advances in computing power, Aegis ships can simultaneously track over 200 targets and engage more than 10 of them at once. They are capable not only of air defense, but also of attacking ground targets, ships, and submarines. The most important aspect of attacking submarines is detecting them. One of the main missiles used by Aegis destroyers is the Standard Missile. Among the Standard Missiles, the SM-3 is designed to intercept ballistic missiles. It has a kill vehicle and a guidance system in its front section and uses two rocket engines to reach high altitudes. First, the radar detects the enemy ballistic missile and transmits the information to the interceptor missile. The missile is launched from the launcher using a booster located at its base. A few seconds after launch, the booster is separated and the rocket engine takes over to increase altitude. The missile flies using an inertial navigation system based on data input just before launch. To correct any errors, satellite navigation is used as a supplementary method. The guidance system continuously receives updated location information of the enemy missile from the Aegis ship and adjusts the missile's trajectory accordingly. As the missile approaches the target, it sheds its protective cover and uses an infrared imaging seeker to distinguish the target's shape. Small rockets are used to precisely control the interceptor's position and orientation. The kill vehicle directly collides with the target to destroy the enemy missile. The SM-3 destroys the enemy warhead during the mid-course phase, before it re-enters the atmosphere. Next, let's look at cruise missiles. They can be launched from ships, submarines, or land-based platforms. They may carry nuclear or conventional warheads to attack ground targets, and they can also fly at very low altitudes to strike enemy ships. This is the Tomahawk cruise missile. At the front, it has an infrared imaging seeker, followed by a digital seam matching area correlation navigation unit. Behind that are the data link and the warhead. It contains a fuel tank and an air intake below. The engine is a turbofan type. It is launched vertically using a rocket booster, which is jettisoned once it reaches a certain altitude. Then, it unfolds its wings and flies using the jet engine. It uses an inertial navigation system and corrects errors using terrain contour matching. Since this method is less effective over deserts or oceans, GPS is used as an additional aid. To avoid enemy radar, it flies at a low altitude. As it approaches the target, it compares the preloaded image data with the live feed from its seeker and attacks when the information matches. This is the Taurus cruise missile. Taurus is an air-to-ground missile launched from a fighter jet. It has a shaped charge warhead at the front and a penetrator warhead at the rear. The shaped charge warhead first creates a hole, and the penetrator warhead behind it follows through the opening. The penetrator uses an impact delay fuse to explode inside the target. This is particularly effective for attacking bunkers located deep underground. That concludes the content I prepared. Thank you for watching.